3v3 Esteel Province Blue Team. We've got two Hive Tyrants. First up is Broodwich. We've also got Floid. These guys are very durable commandos, walk through objects and cannot be suppressed. Some very good offense, disruption and support begin in melee combat with a basic synapse. And alongside them, rounding off the blue team is Rainbow Flavored Pegasus, also known as zeetorq, plays a Warlock, a melee commander that can leap into combat. Some very good offense, disruption and some support too. This is the Exodites Elite Scheme recolored, I believe. Red team, Triple Chaos first up. Real Super Sand, also known as Caeltos, the lead designer of Elite Mod, plays a Plague Champion, starts off range combat with a damage of a time bolter, can get melee weapons, some decent utility and support, can build turrets and repair, but is very slow. Running into some Hormigaunts alongside Jorg as a Chaos Sorcerer, offensive and disruptive Goana, lots of great manipulation and control abilities, and can be pretty killy too. Backing off a Destructor, ouch, on his Heretics. And rounding off, we have all three Chaos Commanders here. Zevargel as a Chaos Lord, durable and destructive commander, walks through objects and cannot be suppressed. Some very good offense and disruption, fights mainly in melee combat. Triple Black Legion, I think. Plague Champion getting pretty low. Looks like Caeltos losing his first Heretic squad. And Chaos Space Marines are going to try and do what they can to hold up Broodwitch's army here. Meanwhile, mid, all kicking off. A 2v2 fight. Hive Tyrant wants to get in amongst those CSM and tie them up quickly. Just bully them. And they might push through and decap, or maybe swing to the east and shoot up this node. We do have CSM and Heretics from Zevargel there to try and hold it up. And Havoc's on the way. Jorg going for double CSM and Caeltos replacing the Heretics that he lost. But Broodwitch with a Warrior Brood. Get Barb Strangler up, maybe. Havoc's also for Jorg, so double CSM into Havoc's. Very solid early build, and it doesn't take that long to get onto the field. As you can see, zeetorq with double Dire Avengers and Howling Banshees. Might want to flank around those Havoc's. I wonder if he'll zoot Rangers once he sees double Havoc's and the whole bunch of CSM and stuff. I think he should get some. Termagants with their toxin sacks on the way. Triple Termagants for Floid. Usually you'll see him get Spore Mines out, so kind of surprised not to see them, especially against Chaos, since they could do so much nasty things against Heretics. What are these guys up to? Hanging out on that western edge. Caeltos, meanwhile, looking at the mid and is capping it, this contested power with his Heretics. And he goes for some more CSM. I think being on the west side where this contested VP is a lot to say about getting the Plague Fist up, since it helps you cap and stuff. He's gone for Fetid Armor right now. It'll help him to control these Hormigaunts. What you want to do is put the Plague Champion at the front of your army so he can use Unholy Stench. There it is. Now he can turn and shoot. These Havocs might want to turn around here. Broodwitch is coming. That's that Hive Tyrant. He might go straight for those Havocs. Doesn't want them turning around. In fact, he's going for the CSM. That's a special attack. Havocs do turn around and they should be able to help force him off. Maybe even take him down. That's a hell of a lot of damage at that close range. And he does go down. Stayed in play a bit too long there, that Hive Tyrant. CSM in retreat for Caeltos. Broodwitch is sewing up this west side. I might want to go after this power right now. 486 to 449. Both Havoc still in play. And we have some Grenade Launcher Heretics for Jorg. Might be able to get some nice spikes of damage on these double Dire Avengers here. Warlock being annoying. Has Merciless Switchblade. Oh, what goes down trying to revive the Hive Tyrant. The Hive Tyrant did get back up though. So they should be able to come and revive this guy. He had Channeling Runes and the Merciless Switchblade, I think. Bile Spear it is for Caeltos. Ouch. Warrior Brood lose a model and Hormigaunts get away with 7 models. That wasn't too bad. So he's got Aspiring Champion Heretics and a pretty good anti-melee Plague Champion with Bile Spear and Fetid. So it might be difficult for that Hormigaunt and Warrior Brood to make another run and do some damage. We will see. It's not always easy to aim that Bilious Discharge accurately, since it does take a second or so to do the animation and get it out. So you need to time it. 486 to 408. Hormagaunts in amongst the Havocs. Get them down to a single model, but they should get away. Melee resistance, of course, on those guys these days. Hive Tyrant has gone for the warp field for Floid and improved synapse, so he might see the very powerful Venom cannon later on. It's the Combi Flamer from the Chaos Lord, pretty much a no-brainer there. Helps you pick off all these Tyranids and also the Eldar, of course. Floid getting a Warrior Brood up now. Would have thought he'd be going tier 2, but I guess not. Jorg is pretty close to going. Once he realizes that is. I want to see some Chosen Plague Marines in tier 2. Love those guys. Decapping is Floyd's stuff. He's not pushing against the power though. I think he knows that Zevargel is coming straight back out of base there. Capping with Hive Tyrant kicking off towards the west side. A turret is up for Caeltos. Doesn't quite do as much damage, I believe, as the Tech Marine's turret, but it does have a wider firing arc, as you can see there. Covering this west side pretty damn well. Heretics getting in there. It's the Hive Tyrant is now trying to focus down. Not doing a huge amount of damage at this range, but as soon as he tries to get closer, it will. He's gone for Extended Carapace. That was an interesting choice, since maybe he got it before he saw the Biosprayer. Maybe he's got it so he can charge, which would make it very difficult to hit the Hive Tyrant with that Ballistic Charge. 441 to 407. VP still pretty close. West side has changed hands a couple of times, and everyone goes tier 2 apart from Floid, who got an extra Warrior Brood up. Well, I say extra. Triple Termagants and Warrior Brood is not something you see very often, so. Is he going to get the Biospew here and go for a massive ranged army? What is he up to? I mean, the Barbed Strangler, not Biospew. He's keeping a melee for now, so he might go for Gene Stealers and have that varied army composition. Still not going tier 2 though. He's floating as of now. Big fighting over here. I think he just needs to back off. Don't try and push against the Havocs. Chaos Lord moving in. In amongst a whole bunch of stuff, he might be getting close for some Immolate action. There's the Crippling Poison. Came up a bit late there. Maybe they had all used it, all three of them. Not sure. He's pushing into the power though. Havocs can come up and cover this whole area here pretty much. Makes your power bashes so much more dangerous when you have a setup team covering it. Can be very difficult to push back out. Look at that. Almost completely covering this side. He needs to flank around. There it is. They're going to lose warrior models if they're not careful. He does get away without losing any. Just trying desperately to stop the power bash here. Just keeping the pressure up. Even if he can't get at that Havoc. To stop them firing on the generators, but he's going to lose the one. What's going on mid? Wow, Jen's up on this contested power here for the red team. Blue team now stealing it. The zone throat for Broodwitch. Floid does go tier 2, and it's Wraithguard for zeetorq. Chaos Dreadnought on the way for Jorg. Don't think he's going to get out in time to have any impact on this engagement. No way, they're already being forced off. Just sheer weight of numbers. Forcing off the Havocs there again. Get away with a single model. I have Tyrant on his way to level 2. Not quite there. Is he going to get that Venom Cannon? I think he might wait. Since it's not a small, but it's 40 power, that thing, that Venom Cannon. Bower Spear doing its work. You see the Billish Discharge there, snaring two of the models pretty hard. And if you get Billish Discharge on something and then use your basic attack, you are pretty much rooting it to the ground. There's Touch of Nurgle on no CSM. Touch of Nurgle went through some pretty major changes, of course, in 2.4.2. It now heals based on the health of the squad you used it on. Does 33% of their health as a heal and is now even less effective as a result on Heretics, and does less damage on Heretics now, even less than it did before, down to 25 damage on Heretics. Rangers on the field for zeetorq. Pretty amazing once you get their Pathfinder gear up. Here's that Dreadnought though. Don't really have an answer for it apart from the Wraithguard. They do have the Executioner spear up for the Howling Banshees. Executioner weapon is what they call it here. Takes the form of a spear. Wow. Havoc's getting absolutely owned. Wipe out. Yes, they know. They were strangely split up there. They do get away. Banshees doing some good work though. Look how much fire they drew there from this blob of chaos stuff. And now Wraithguard can go to work. Big changes for these guys, of course. They do have their Wraith Sight Spirit Seer guy. I think he's technically just a Warlock. There he is. But they're a bit slower now, as you can see. Zone Throat getting shots in. Big armies for the blue team. We have Zone Throats on both players. There is the Chains of Tormite. Can they shoot down this Zone Throat now? No, does retreat out in time. Hive of Tyrant gets the Venom Cannon. That is direct response to that Chaos Dreadnought, I believe. He's got Extended Carapace, which is a little bit awkward. Kind of charge in and then start shooting your Venom Cannon. He can use it as counter-initiation, actually. If he sees a melee squad starting to come in, such as this Chosen Plague Marines, he could just charge them down and disrupt. These are a unique unit for the Plague Champion with power melee weapons that do damage over time. They can also use Nurgle's Rot, which can spawn zombies if a unit dies under its effect. Now they have melee resist, big pool of health and good health regen. They are a really good unit, I think. They don't have a melee charge though, so you generally want to keep them back and wait for stuff to come to them. But you can just send them in to draw fire. 325, 370 is tier 3 for Caeltos. Zevargel is already there. In fact, did he get anything out in tier 2? I'm not sure. I don't think he did. But it's discharged just to deny that ground. They don't want to move through it, so they're going around here. Chosen Plague Marines using the shot blocker of this wall. We have some Adrenal Gland Warriors. Now they have that synapse feedback type thing, as you see on the tooltip there. It's a pretty epic tooltip. Lots of stuff to explain on Adrenal Glands. 306 to 370. CSM a bit late to react. Now in amongst Tormungons. Looks like he's happy to fight it with some Heretic support here. Heretic's taking shots though. Taking a lot of shots. And now they're off the field. Chosen Plague Marines now off the field. Banshee's chasing them down. That is some Channeling Runes usage there. Level 3 for the Warlock. And now Caeltos is completely off the field. Jorg is alone. And that Wraithguard is doing work. Needs a way to tie them up. What is the Sorcerer doing? He's back at base. Does not have vestments of the warp, of course, and this is a dead Dreadnought. Not sure why he wasn't moving it. It got hit by the Zone Throat Focus Warp Blast, but still should have been able to move, I suppose. Maybe he thought it was futile. Red team under pressure here. They're going to lose that west side. Blue team have this eastern contested power, though. Floid with a Brood Nest using it to push ahead and some Capillary Towers for that mobility advantage. Is going to push against the power, at least try to. In fact, there's nothing to push against. This power's going to be completely wiped down to its bare power node. Not even the node, just the power point itself. Some corn worship for these bloodletters. And we might see some terminators dropped over here for Zevargel. Just needs 550 rec and a bit more red, which he should be able to get in the next engagement. Red team now fighting off the blue team. Yes, the Hive Tyrant's off the field. What else is around? Zone Throat is still in play. And so is his Warrior Brood and those Formagons who are under that Adrenal Gland melee synapse. His Chosen Plague Marines that are drawing fire here. Battle Spear is still doing its thing. That's a Ballista Discharge. You get pretty decent range on it. As you can see, it was able to hit those Banshees. And he's got the Icon of Nurgle up, so he's going to try and get close. I suppose it plays into the low range of the Bile Spear. I'm not sure what the rate. There's a radius 22 on the Icon of Nurgle, which I'm guessing is lower than the Bile Spear. Bile Spear is probably around 26 or 28 or so. 285 to 317. We have Mark of Zeech CSM going to turn around and start shooting at that Warrior Brood, I would guess. Or not. Just forced him off, kind of running around there. 285 to 310. Havoc's having to back away. They're getting shot to pieces, just about get away there. It's a Land Raider Phobos on the way for Zevargel. That's what he's gone for. Decent choice, I think, since Floid could respond with Neurothrope if he got Terminators up. Plague Champion now level 4. What's going on? We have a Sorcerer at level 2. Rose of Torment, Sigil of the Rift. And a level 2 Chaos Lord does have Armored Inferno. Pretty much, again, a no-brainer purchase, I think, in this situation. Can set up some really good stuff with it. There it is. Only really hit a Termagant Brood. Are the Warrior Brood going to want to fight those Bloodletters? I don't think they are. Hormagaunt support, though, and they're going into fight with that Synapse Feedback, giving them huge buffs to their damage since they're triple Termagants and Hormagaunt's around. Hormagaunt's trying to make it in to the Havocs. Where's his Zone Throw back? Oh, it's back there. Take getting shots in. Hormagaunt's doing so much work here. Doing a hell of a lot of work. Down goes the Chaos Lord. Floid has the Crushing Claw. 108 heavy melee DPS. It's so powerful. Attacks really quickly, so you don't get those big bursts of damage off it. But if anything stands in front of the Hive Tyrant for any length of time, it is going to die. Levels up to 3 now, meaning those Crushing Claws are doing even more damage. Zone Throat being a bit risky, but does get away. In fact, levels to 2 before it retreats out. Lots of good pressure here from Floid. He has locked down his power for quite a while, but here comes a Phobos. Dirge Caster is going to be useful as well. Really useful in engagements. Be aggressive with the Dirge Caster. And a Carnifex on the way for Floid. No doubt that will be a Venom Cannon. He might go for a Thornback though, since the Dirge Caster stun will not affect the Carnifex, I'm pretty sure. Bowspear, that would have been very, very painful. Barb Strangler even. Why do I keep calling these things Bowspears? So Barb Strangler Carnifex. Not a Bowspear Carnifex, though that would be cool. Big chunks of Plasma Cannon damage per shot, as you see there. Would have been really painful to those CSM if they didn't retreat. Out with some Seer Council up under Channeling Runes. The Warlock can do some really good things to support his Seer Council. You've got Enhance, you've got Channeling Runes, you've got Cloak of Shadows. And yeah, Chosen Plague Marines don't want to fight those guys with Channeling support. 285, 261 is very, very even on VPs. Wow, look at that Barb Strangler doing work. Great Unclean One is on the field for Caeltos. Jorg looking a little thin with double CSM and Heretics. Lost his Dreadnought, obviously. And he had some Havocs as well, I believe, which he's lost with... I think he had the Auto Cannon on them. Seems like Zevargel's happy to guard this power, hang out around here for now. He's waiting for Floid to push back, and here is the Carnifex, and he's gone for the Thornback. Ripper Swarm is spawned to try and draw some fire. Warpfield able to tank for the Hive Tyrant, and he's helping out all of his stuff with the improved synapse. Ripper Swarm is sent in to be annoying, and they are annoying. You see that Twin Link Heavy Bolt being doing barely any damage. It's because it's struggling to hit them. 285, 261. What's going on west side? Great Unclean One is leading the line. Gonna try and tie up that Carnifex. There we go. So it can't fire that very dangerous Barb Strangler. Boom. Suppressing the CSM there. Down goes the Zone Throat, set up by the Foul Snare. Zone Throats are so squishy. Used the Nurgle Vomit thing, which didn't do a whole lot to the Carnifex there. Still tying it up. Doing damage passively in an area around the Great Unclean One. What's going on mid though? Massive engagement. There's a nuke from Zevargel. The Dirge Caster not stopping the Carnifex. And the Hive Tyrant's right there, but is forced off. In fact, retreats through the Abyss, but does get away. Big engagement here. Can the Phobos stand up to this Carnifex? Now a Mark of Khorne Havoc getting shots in. This Carnifex needs to be really careful here. Phobos doing massive chunks of damage with those last cannons. Can it get away? He's going to try and charge away. Thankfully for the Carnifex, there were no snares around, so it might be able to just walk back to base here after that charge. There we go. It was well judged in the end by Floid. Can he take out his heretics? Down to 5 hit points. Just needs one more hit. Hormogons are chasing, but they can't quite get it. And runs into base turrets, but they weren't. Yes, they were suppressed. So there is the full retreat out. Another Phobos, this time from Jorg. And we have Zevargel with a Chaos Predator on the way. It's a pretty good map for tanks in general, I think. They have a decent amount of space to move around. Can get a bit tight in the mid, but not too bad. Compared to some of the other urban maps, which can be a death trap for your tanks. Here's a Las Cannon turret. This thing does not mess around. That kind of effect needs to be afraid. Predator hits the field right now. What does he go for? Mark of Khorne or Mark of Nurgle maybe? We'll just leave with default. Wait for maybe a large target to hit field. I suppose the Mark of Zinch would help shoot down the Carnifexes, which are inevitably going to roll out of the Tyranid bases. There's already three on the field that I can see. Two for Broodwich, one for Floid. Who's going to engage and where are they going to engage? Perhaps more importantly, is it time to start fighting over this concession, or are we going to see a fight over the natural VPs here? Plague Champion seemed to be moving very, very quickly there, the Plague Champion. What was that? Now he's slowed down. The Plague Champion is completely bugged out. Look at his war gear. There's the Icon of Nurgle in his weapon slot. What is going on there? That is very strange. 239, 223. Very, very strange indeed. Never seen that bug in a replay. I assume it is just a replay bug and he still has all of the gear he's meant to have. Dirtcaster doing a lot of work. Double grenades thrown in on those heretics. Couldn't quite hit. Flush though. Don't really have any AV from zeetorq apart from the Wraith Guard, which is pretty strong AV, especially against a massive target like a Land Raider. Bang. Barb Strangler doing work on the Chosen Plague Marines, forcing off the Venom Cannon Hive Tyrant. They do a lot for you against those single entities because that damage over time stacks indefinitely from those Plague Knives, although obviously it does have a duration. Where's the Grand Imperial for Caeltos? Coming out of base, I think, under some Nurgle Worship. And wow, look at the damage from that Las Cannon turret on that Carnifex. It does get out of the firing arc just about. It looks like Red Team are going to take this contested VP. I think zeetorq needs to come fully over to this west side. He's got the nuke, so could Eldritch one of these foe bosses, maybe even both of them, if they blob up, but looks like they are keeping them kind of separate. Maybe he can hit the turret and a foe boss. That would be pretty good. Noise Marines on the way for Jorg, maybe for an instant Blastmaster upgrade. The Warlock is down here, but I think Broodwich can come out and revive pretty easily. In fact, here he is coming out of base with that speed buff from the Capillary Towers. Oh, Plague Champion now has his war gear back. That was really weird. Fetid Armor, Bile Spear, Icon of Nurgle is level 6. Is he actually capping there? I can't see the indicator. Very strange. Buggy replay here. Can't see the capping indicator. There we go, now it's red. Another Las Cannon turret. Wow. Benefix needs to stay the hell back. Can send in the Wraith Guard first. Oh, he lost his Wraith Guard. I say he could send in the Wraith Guard first to take those turrets out pretty quickly. There's a Singularity which misses absolutely everything. Apart from a Phobos, I guess, but it's not going to throw a Phobos around. Grand T1 happy to just take shots from this Venom Cannon. Here's a massive engagement right now. That's a Eldritch Storm, surely. Yes, it is. On the Phobos. Wow. Huge amounts of damage, but can they follow it up and take this thing down? Here come some Carnifexes and a Swarm Lord I spotted there from Floid. Looks like he's coming over to the west side, but can they finish off the Phobos? Grenades thrown in as desperation, but he's going to survive here. 191-204. Floid is busy going after this other Phobos, and I think they're both going to survive here. There's that Swarm Lord giving the Hive Tyrant and the Carnifex a speed boost, which is pretty damn scary. Also gives you a reinforcement synapse. Nothing close enough to reinforce though, and his termagants are taking a lot of damage. Being chased by bloodletters. He's gonna lose maybe all of his termagants if he's not careful. They're now reinforcing off the swarmer. The Phobos lives. And this is kind of dicey for Floid. He's deep in enemy territory and there's two Phobosses around to shoot at his monstrous creatures. They do have vehicle armor if you were wondering. There's a Zinchi nuke from Jorg taking out two of the termagants, but looks like the monstrous creatures are gonna get away. Maybe. No, he lost one of his Carnifexes. Did he have two Carnifexes? I don't think he did. No, it was Broodwich with multiple Carnifexes. He has three of them now. Wow. Is that triple Barb Strangler? That is going to be insane. If they don't misfire. There we go. Smack. Warrior Brood chasing the Great Unclean One. Here comes a Seer Council and Howling Banshees. Maybe they can chop up those turrets. Cloud of Flies on the Warrior Brood who are trying to take down a triple Las Cannon turrets. Wow. Look at that damage on those Carnifexes. They are not lasting very long at all. He has set himself up really well to fight monstrous creatures. But down goes a Great Unclean One. The cannon needs to be firing at the turrets, I think, if it can. This big tree stump thing is a shot blocker, which is why it's not firing on those Carnifexes right now. Gets one shot, but he's actually forcing melee with the Carnifexes. And he should be able to take down that turret. And that's all of the turrets down. And the Great Unclean One down. Now calls in some Terminators. Was that a good idea? With multiple Barb Strangler Carnifexes. He's going to take down one of them. There we go. It was a good idea. Instantly takes out a Carnifex. With a Mark of Nurgle Predator from Zevargel. Gives it some health regen. A big chunk of hit points. Up to 12. 25 at level 1. And importantly, gives it melee synapse, which is pretty awesome. Carnifex gets away. That's two nukes, I think, is it? I think it is. I think that's Zevargel's nuke and Caeltos' nuke right on top of each other, pretty much. Painful. 176 to 180. It's the Plague Champion who's capping that Western Contested VP at level 7. Have Tyrants only level 3 for Floid. Not always easy to get into melee combat and do your damage. Lictor out. We have Venom Brood on the way for Broodwitch. These Phobos has done really well. And zeetorq is seriously wreck starved. Tough. It's tough. He needs to get some Bright Lances up on this west side, I think. This is where both of the Phobosses are, right? Where's the other one? No, it's mid. Basically just guarding their VP right now, because I know blue team are going to just send waves of stuff crashing against it. Can they rebuff this assault? Well, instantly the Seer Council forced off by the Little Galaxy Burn. The Curse Lord also has the Blood Maw right now. Howling Banshee trying to get to the Havocs, but that's not going to work out too well for them. And they easily defend there. Floid now coming west side. Everything getting speed buffs from that swarm lord. That is scary. A speed buff Lictor. Mark Rosine CSM up to level 4. Getting some serious frame rate issues right now. I have Tyrant with Psychic Scream for Broodwitch. And that's a lot of heavy melee stuff going after the Phobos. The Dirtcaster slows down the Hive Tyrant and the Lictor, and there's a Chains of Torment for good measure, but looks like this Phobos is going down. Swarmlord and Carnifex going after it, and a Tunnel Formation getting a shot in, but the Phobos lives somehow. Some Corn Worship helping it to get out of there. 21 hit points. Are you serious? Down it goes. Carnifex getting in with a melee charge and takes it down. There's a Nurgle Shrine for Caeltos with his chosen Plague Marines alongside. That is a pretty nasty combo. So they send the attack off, or do they? Carnifex and Swarmlord are still running around here. Barb Strangler, Carnifex, the only remaining one that Broodwitch has. What is this Predator tank? This is Zevargel's level 3 now. Mark of Nurgle one. Taking melee hits, but tanking them reasonably well here. didn't take a rear armor hit. Does it make it immune to rear arm hits or something? That's a bit odd. 127 to 166 is still so close. Just constant action once everyone hit tier 3 pretty much. And everyone still has pretty sizable armies here. Usually by this point someone has a really bad engagement and puts their team behind. I suppose Broodwich losing two Carnifexes wasn't great, but they're still in contention big time on this west side. Zeetorq seems to have struggled to get that big marquee unit on the field. I suppose he has a D-Cannon and a Seer Council, but you'd expect to be seeing Fire Prisms on this map. Lightning Claw Terminators get inside the Phobos, and there's that Dirtcaster again. More Terminators over here. These are Caeltoses with the auto cannon, taking massive amounts of damage from that Barbed Strangler. But they do take down the D-Cannon. Can they teleport out though? Yes, they can. Back to the shrine where they can reinforce as well, now that it's being worshipped. Blue team have it though. There's a Noxious Cloud. Don't think it's going to take down the Venom Brood. No, runs out. 127 to 148. Blue team are going after red team's natural, I think. Hive Tyrant now level 4. There's a tier 3 Lictor infiltrated, doing all sorts of mischief. Hive Tyrant's down. But so is that shrine now. Chaos Terminators for Jorg need some heal support, and now they don't have that shrine to stand around. This Swarmlord and Carnifex are doing so much work. This Carnifex almost level 3. They're holding up red team for a hell of a long time. Looks like now they're going to be pushed off. Phobos of Jorg, of course, still around and doing work. Carnifex needs to be careful. Gets a shot on the autocannon Terminators, who did purchase a reinforcement off the shrine, but the shrine went down before he could actually come into play there. Neurothroat for Broodwitch. Now that there's two Chaos Terminators on the field, that's a pretty good choice. Down goes a Carnifex though. I told you, you needed to be careful. Both the naturals are still on their natural colours. So it's all about this west side right now, but I imagine we're going to see a push for one of the naturals soonish. Here's that Neurothroat for Broodwitch. Really powerful against blobs of super heavy and heavy infantry with its paroxysm. Can also disrupt though and lock down a unit with its spirit leech or whatever it's called. I think it's called that. Which allows it to drain energy, does a little bit of damage, and now locks down, or disables rather, a unit. So good versus single entities, especially apothecaries and stuff, where it's often engagement critical that they're able to do something when they want to, i.e. get a heal off. Another Phobos from Zevargel here. Why not? They're doing really well with them. Lack of AV, I think, from Zeetorq is kind of slowing the team down here. Still got no wreck at all. He must be really bleeding hard on that Seer Council and Howling Banshees. Is there anything he can really do with them? That's a paroxysm. Predator level 3, able to tank damage pretty well from the Venom Brute. There's a Dirtcaster, and yeah, that melee blob of Eldar's finding it tough to make an impact here. Maybe he should take those guys mid and push through to that natural and try and do some work there. There is another Phobos there though. That Dirtcaster is painful. Need to try and bait it out. But how? That's a Tyranid formation almost wiping out those Havocs. Is that more Terminators or did they just teleport? They just teleported. Big rush here. Double Carnifexes for Floid with that speed boost from the Swarmlord is pretty damn scary with double Thornbacks, but that's double Phoboses to shoot you up. Needs to be careful. Doesn't want to lose that Carnifex. I think he will. Surely it's going to be chased down here. Got to chase it down. One more shot. No, he can't. Yes, he can. Gets a shot off. 86 to 63. A double cap now for Blue. It's so close. Oh, look at that. Zeetorq does get a Fire Prism up. Does he have an Eldritch? I think he does. Yes. Eldritch can be used here. This could be really, really important. to either stop a cap or finish off a Phobos. Maybe he's going to look to lose it on this guy right here. Dirge Caster is still going off, but the stun either did not hit those guys. Oh, I hear a Phobos, hear an Eldritch, I mean. Did he take out a shrine or something? What did he? Why did he use it there? He was chasing this Phobos, but used it on this one. That was weird. Another tier 3 elixir for Floid. It's 86 to 46. Someone needs to take this west side, obviously. But what is going to be able to? They do have some decent capping units, the red team. They have Terminators. They have Chosen Plague Marines. They have the Plague Champion himself, who's now level 9. Is it time to get that fist up? He doesn't have the resources to do so right now. Here comes that Fire Prism. It's the Hive Tyrant trying to cap. Psychic Scream doesn't really help him cap, though. Everything getting shots in. No pushes from the Naturals, from what I can see. Terminator's moving in to try and draw some fire here and chop up that Warrior Brood. Can it get something to cap? So Mark of Korn CSM really late from Caeltos, level 4. Were they late? I didn't see them. First time I've seen them, in a way. Terminators are capping. Is this the end of the game here? Maybe not. Look at this push from blue team on the mid. This is Floid and zeetorq. Predator getting a mark. Not a good time to get one. Now it has Mark of Nurgle, though. Might help it get away. Blastmaster covering the VP from way back. Chosen Plague Marines doing huge amounts of damage to the Hive Tyrant. Can they force it off, though? It is a very tanky one. At level 4 now, with 1400 hit points and 130 energy to power the warp field. Can they get this cap off? Very brave level 4 Dire Avengers might do this here. 80 to 46. They do. No, they didn't get the cap. They retreated too quickly. They do get away with one hit point, though. I think it should have finished the cap there. It might have been important. It would have given them a 2 to 1 for a little while at least. Down goes the Hive Tyrant. Was just trying to hold up the cap there. Red team have the west. They have their natural back, and there's the 2-1. Blue team still have a lot of units to push, though. Throw a formation. Too late to stop the cap, but does force off a bunch of stuff. And now maybe that Lictor can get at least a decap. You'd think he'd get the decap at least. He's trying to hold up play here with the Swarm Lord and the Carnifex. Hive Tyrant back on his feet. It was the Warlock that got the cap there using Providence. Also has Witchblade of Kurnos and Warp Throat. Phobos being chased by a Carnifex. There's a nuke. Nuke's going to be really important now. Down goes a Lictor and it stopped the cap there. Does anyone else have a nuke? I think Jorg. Oh, Jorg's reasonably close. Floid also reasonably close. Down goes that Carnifex, though. Just desperation from Floid to just try and get that VP. Still has the Swarm Lord, but it's under half health. That guy, of course, can't level up either. So he's stuck at 2,000. What's going on west side? Can't push against the Phobos still. Can they finish it off here? That's a Venom Cannon Carnifex. He might go after it. I guess not. Another Nurgle Shrine there, keeping those capillary towers around though. Still, all the action on this natural VP of red team. They're holding it for now, and they still have that 2-1. Blue team need to triple and go somewhere with it. It looks like they're trying to triple mid right now, because here comes Broodwich, but he needs to wait. He's doing this too quickly. I think he needs to wait for the rest of his team to get back out here. We'll see. Maybe they'll get a decap with these Banshees. Banshees with the Distort Field on them. That's a Noxious Cloud coming up from Caeltos. Hitting a hell of a lot of stuff there. Broodwich kind of ran into it. Is he going to finish the cap? Knocked off it by the Armory Inferno. They did so much damage as well with the Noxious Cloud. Leveled the Chaos Lord up to level 10, 17, 51 hit points. Wow, he's got the Icon of Korn as well. 41, 46. Red team are going to get the 2-1 again. Fire Prism can't knock over the Chaos Lord. He's going for the Dark Halo now. So he's going to be pretty energy intensive with Kill the Weak and Sweeping Doom and Armory Inferno, or Let the Galaxy Burn, I should say. 37-46. Do blue team have one more push left in them? Neurothrope throws out a paroxysm. Looks like Floyd's going over the west side. There's a lot of stuff there, though. Including a Laz Cannon and a Phobos. Laz Cannon not in the firing arc, though, to hit this Carnifex right here. They're keeping the pressure up on both sides. The mid and the west. There's even some heretics here with grenade launchers to stop the cat. If it comes down to it. They can't knock a Hive Tyrant off, of course. Carnifex down to 30 hit points. Going to be taken out by the autocannon, I would guess. Down it goes. 10-46. Blue team running out of time, running out of ideas. And looks like red team are going to take this game with a 2-1 in an epic struggle. Just constant action for the last like 20 minutes or so of this match. And there is the victory. Wow, even a turret at the end of the game there was most likely going to keep it a heavy bolter, I guess. And look at the commander's end of the game. We have a level 5 Hive Tyrant for Broodwich with the Venom Cannon, level 7 Warlock. Took a while to get his Fire Prism up, but he did eventually hit. He seemed to bleed a hell of a lot from the Seer Council and the Banshees. He did level them up, though. Hive Tyrant is level 6 with Crushing Claw for Floid. Level 10 Plague Champion. He did get the Fist by the end of the game. Level 8 Sorcerer and a level 10 Chaos Holders. Frantic stuff. But the Chaos team takes it. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. And I'll see you next time.